हेलो एवरीवन, नमस्कार, वेलकम टू पाई स्क्वायर एकेडमी. दिस इज बुलबुल शर्मा विद अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक टुडे. टुडेज टॉपिक इज व्हाट इज पर यूनिट. व्हाई इज पर यूनिट. सो मोर ऑफ सच वाई सीरीज क्वेश्चंस लाइक वाई 50 हर्ट्ज, वाई ट्रांसफॉर्मर इन केवीए, यू कैन चेक the link in the description below. Those who are new to the channel, do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get notified from Pi Square Academy. Now getting back to the question of what is per unit. I want to give you a very day-to-day example to understand this. Let us assume that there is a girl who is studying at some college and has scored 40 marks in electrical machines. And let there be a boy of some other college who has scored 80 marks in electrical machines. Now, if I ask you, the girl who has scored 40 and the boy who has scored 80, out of these, who is a better performer? What will you say? Obviously the boy. But I'll say that is wrong. Why? Because the girl who has scored 40 in that college, the total marks of electrical machines is 50. And the guy who belongs to another college, the total marks machines is 500. From machines, I should say, Pi Square Academy has also launched full courses for electrical machines. You can find the link below. Now, she has scored 40 out of 50 in some college and he has scored 80 out of 500 in some other college. So now if we look at these scores, then when we try to compare that whose performance is better, we need a common reference or base. We need a common reference or base, according to which we need to compare both of them. So whatever base you take or reference you take, we need to scale our values to that base or reference. Suppose I take 500 as the base, then I need to bring this score to 500. That means I need to multiply both the denominator and the numerator by 10. So it becomes 400 by 500, and it is already having the base as 500. So it will be 80 by 500. So now when we remember that the absolute values which were given was 40 and 80, and now we take the reference as 500 and try to scale it up, we can see that the boy was not a better performer than the girl. But at the starting we used to assume that the boy was a better performer. So now someone will say, why just 500? Why not 50? Okay, fine. I can take 50 as the base too. When I'm trying to take the base to 50, it is already at a reference of 50. So I can just write down 40 by 50. It is at a base of 500. So I'll try it to take to the reference of 50. So I need to divide both the denominator and the numerator by 10. So it becomes 8 by 50. Yeah, so now also I can see that the girl is the better performer. Let's not take 50 and 500 and someone wants to take some other reference. Let us take 100. So this base or reference that is 100 is in our terms known as per cent. Cent means 100. Or this 100 reference is known as per cent. Fine? So percent, which is the common reference taken by everyone for showing up the marks. Now we will try to show this one in terms of percent. So if we take 100 as the reference, then we need to multiply this by 100. 40 by 50 into 100. How much that is? 80 by 100. Now similarly, I have to scale this 200. When I am trying to scale this 200, again multiplied by 100. That means it is 16 by 100. 16 per 100. So per cent or per 100, how much is this value? Now in the same way as it is per cent, if I take 1 as the reference, if I take 1 as the base or the reference, that is only known as per unit. Per 1 or per unit. Per unit. So this, when you choose 1 as the reference or the base, that is known as per 1 or per unit. So if I take this in terms of 1, then it becomes 0.8 per unit, and this becomes 0.16 per unit. So now this explains you what is per unit. Whenever we are comparing two quantities, then we need to have a common reference or a base. May it be 500, may it be 50, may it be 20, may it be 100, may it be 1. So when it is per 100, it is known as per cent. When it is per 1 or per unit, that is what we are talking about. So now we can easily compare which one is a better form. Now, question arises, why in case of power systems, we take only per unit instead of per cent or per 20 or per 50? Why we consider only per unit? For that, you have to watch the video till the end. I'll get back to that. Now, why per unit is considered in case of power system? Let us take a power system network where this is 10 kV. I am using a step of transformer which is 1:20 ratio. So it is stepping up the 10 kV to 200 kV, 20 times. Then suppose I am having a transformer that is stepping down, let us say by 2:1 or half, then 200 kV becomes 100 kV. Now let me have a transformer which is again stepping down by the ratio of 10:1. So again 10 kV. So 10 kV over this part, which is again giving 10 kV. Okay. So this is a power system network I have taken. Suppose that if I try to compare this power system network to the example I have taken, the girl's code 40 out of 50. Correct? Now this girl is going to some abroad country for higher studies, where they want in the range of 100 what is her score. So should she send a 40? No. She need to scale up her marks to the range of 1000. So 1:20, when the total marks they are saying is 1000, you need to multiply it by 20. So 50 into 20 is becoming 1000, and then again 40 into 20, it becomes 800. So in that country, this 40 marks becomes 800 because their total marks range is 1000. Again, further, she wants to study in some other countries where they need the scale to be down to 500. So this is reduced by half to 500, her marks, total marks. Now again, she need to scale her 800 marks back to this range. That means this is divided by 2. So you need to divide this by 2, becomes 400. Now again, she is going back to her own country. So her marks will again be divided by 10, that is 50. And 400 divided by 10, it becomes 40. So now you can see that the marks we have taken needs to be ranged to the total marks that is in some other country. So here in this country it is 1000, here it is 5000. So you need to scale your marks to that level. So I want to relate now that this total power system network, you can take any reference or base. So you can, for this, you can take reference or base as 20 kV, as 200 kV, as 10 kV, anything you can take as the base. But this scaling factor will always be there, or you need to range it to this factor. Okay, so suppose I take 11 kV as the base. I took 11 kV as the base. I'll say this is the base. Then since there is a factor of 1:20 over here, or the transformer is stepping up 20 times, so you need to scale the base up to 20 times. So now it will be scaled to 11 kV into 20, that is 220 kV. Now again, we are using another transformer which is stepping it down by 2. So again, this is 220 kV into 1/2, that is 110 kV. Now at last, we have the transformer that is again stepping down by 10 times. So again, what I'll do, 110 kV into 1/10, it comes to 11 kV, and that was our base amount. So any base you choose, may it be 11 kV or 22 kV, you have always to consider the scaling factor, and you have to range, you have to reach that range. Whatever base you take, you can take 11 kV, you can take So from looking at this, when I try to formulate it to a formula, then I can say, you see, when I'm trying to find out the base of the secondary side of the transformer, that is V secondary base is equal to, you see how much it is? V primary base. This was the primary base. This is the secondary base. So when you are trying to find out the secondary base, equals to primary base into, this is how much? N2/N1. Or from this formula also you can say, when you are trying to find out the primary base, then it is equals to secondary base into N1/N2. So you can easily find out what is the secondary base or the primary base. You can relate this, or everybody knows this formula. You can easily relate this to the transformer formula, in which V was proportional to N, voltage was proportional to the number of turns, and Vs by Vp was equal to Ns by Np. So you can easily relate this. You always need to range your base according to the scaling factor of the transformer, but base can be chosen as anything. Now coming to our typical part, that is, why are we not considering percent, but we are considering per unit in case of power system network. Now coming to this question, percent or this voltage or ratio or watt, whatever thing, is having some mathematical calculations that may be summation, that may be subtraction, that may be multiplication, anything. So let me take a very common thing, that power equals to V into I. Let me consider this multiplication formula for a power system network. So when I am trying to consider this one, then let us see what happens if I take in percent and what happens if I take in per unit. Let me say, I'll create a table, okay, where this is your percent table and this one is your per unit table. So suppose I say the voltage V is reduced by 50%. The current I is reduced by 50%. Then what do you think the power should reduce by? How much? 25%. But when in this case I am trying to find out the power and multiplying this both, then it becomes 2500%. That means whatever final product of power I am getting, I need to divide that by 100 again to get the percentage of power. But when I take it in case of per unit, then the voltage is reduced by half, the current is reduced by half, and when I multiply both of them, the power is reduced by 1/4. So you can see the difference. When I am doing in case of percent, then the power is reduced by 2500%. I need to divide again by 100 to get the product. But in this case, per unit case, you simply don't have to divide or multiply by anything. Simple multiplication, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, so it is 1 by 4. So to reduce the complex calculations or so much of hustle and bustle, we choose per unit in case of power systems. So concluding all of this, I can say per unit is per one, or a reference or base which is with respect to one. When you are having a transformer, it is a kind of base or reference we need to range back to. Whatever value we are having over here, we need to multiply it by the transformer to get it to the range. Coming to this, we consider per unit to avoid the extra calculations like this one, like I gave the example. So that is all about today's video. I hope you must have liked the video. Do like, comment and share. Those who are new to the channel, do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get more videos from Pi Square Academy. Thank you.